Now the key with wet blending is always to be working into a wet area of paint. You never want to be trying to blend over a dried area of paint. For example, if I take the mid-tone color, apply it to the area that I want to paint, generally somewhere around the center section of any particular area you're going to blend, you lay down the mid-tone, you take the next highlight color, you lay it into about half of the mid-tone. And then you take your brush and you're going to feather that transition between where the mid-tone and the highlight color is. As you can see with this miniature, I've base coated it already with this ashen blue from Reaper. You'll see it covers most of the primer up. It's ready to go for blending. So when I wet blend, I always start wet into wet. So I put down a little bit of the base coat, in this case this ashen blue, just to make the area damp so I can then work into it. Now I'll move up to the next color, which is this snow shadow. You want to pick out where the highlight's going to be on the fold. So in this particular case, the light's hitting right here, so I'm going to start blending into that area right there. I'm trying to feather it into the wet area as I go up toward the shadow above it. Now if I need to, I come back in with a little bit of this ashen blue in the shadow area and just kind of feather the edge to get that nice and smooth. Okay, so you've done your initial wet blend. You've blended the mid-tone color with the next highlight. Now you'll take a little bit of that next highlight color, you'll again paint a wet layer of paint toward the top of that previous highlight.